What's up, guys? In this tutorial, I will show you how to fix blurry textures and improve your overall graphics quality when playing Dying Light 2 on your PC. This should be quite an easy tutorial. For more information, click on the first link in the description below. Launch Dying Light 2 and navigate to your in-game settings. In the Video tab, make sure to set the window mode to windowed borderless. Below, change your resolution to your native monitor resolution, which is the one marked with a star. The Upscaler mode has a very high impact on the visual quality and textures of the game, as it can help you upscale your in-game resolution and help get a much higher frame rate. In case the DLSS quality option is available to you, then make sure to select it. This will use your graphics card to upscale the graphics quality and help you get a more stable frame rate. Another good choice would be the FSR quality mode. Quality simply means that the game tries to leave you with some good visual quality while getting more FPS. For very low-end PCs struggling to run the game, it's suggested to set this option to DLSS performance or FSR performance. Turn off the film grain effect and set the motion blur quality option to none. You can then navigate to your advanced video settings when using the F key. Here, make sure to use the DirectX 12 as the renderer mode instead of DirectX 11 in case it's available to you. Otherwise, use DirectX 11. Below, you can increase the sharpness option, which is set to 45 by default, to around 50 to 60. This will also depend on which resolution you are playing. When applying your changes, you should notice that the blurry textures problem will be fixed and that your graphics quality will have improved by a lot. In case you have low system performance after applying these changes, then make sure that your graphics driver and operating system is up to date. For more tips on how to increase your frame rate and overall performance when playing Dying Light 2, make sure to follow my FPS boost guide linked in the description below. In case you have any further issues or problems following this tutorial, then I suggest following my extensive guide linked in the description below. I hope this helped you out. Leave a comment if you have any questions, and see you in the next one.